expressing your thankfulness is the highest form of thought, and it is an honor for me that I have been given this opportunity to propose the vote of thanks. On behalf of the School of Management Sciences, Lucknow, I would like to thank our distinguished chief guest, Professor Rana Singh Sir, for accepting our invitation and for being with us today. I would like to thank our guest of honor, Professor Dheeraj Mehrotra, who kindly consented to bless us with his presence. Your thoughts have truly inspired us, sir. Thank you so much. We are extremely grateful to Shri Viren Kumar Ji while the introduction of Viren Kumar Ji was being read, a point was missed. And sir, with your permission, I would like to bring to the notice of the August House that Shri Viren Kumar Ji is a very good painter as well. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Virendra Kumar Ji, for gracing us with your kind words. Hearty thanks to all academicians, researchers, eminent speakers, distinguished guests, corporate leaders, for enlightening us during this two-day conference. Thanks are also due to our sponsors for supporting us, and to the members of the media for covering the conference during the last 2 days. On behalf of the organizing committee, although our CEOs are not present here, but on behalf of the organizing committee and on my own behalf, I would like to extend my sincere gratitude to the CEO and secretary of SMS, Shri Sharad Singh, who reposed his faith in me and entrusted me with the responsibility of organizing this conference. I shall always remain indebted to our director, Dr. Manoj Mehrotra sir, who has always been a pillar of strength and guidance, standing right behind us whenever we need the support. Thank you so much, sir. I convey my deep regards to our Director General Technical, Dr. B.R. Singh sir, whose amazing energy is a continuous source of inspiration for all of us. Thank you so much, sir. And we hope that you keep us inspiring the same way. My sincere thanks to our CGM and GM, who facilitated the logistics and provided the administrative support wherever it was required. Now, despite being new to this organization, it was my privilege to get the support of an able and efficient team of colleagues who were members of various committees and who, with their relentless efforts, ensured that everything was planned to perfection and executed with precision. Thank you, my dear colleagues, for extending your support. I take pride in saying that my real strength are my young and energetic students who participate in all institutional activities with full zeal and exuberance. Thank you, dear students, for being there always whenever I needed you. For being a part of this national conference. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. The end of this story is the new beginning for many others. On this note, let's conclude a remarkable, memorable, and knowledgeable conference on SDG 9. On behalf of SMS Lucknow, we sincerely thank the dignitaries for being with us this evening and enlightening us with their deep learning. I shower my heartfelt gratitude to the professors and SMS family for their wholehearted support rendered in the success of this conference. Thank you very much. I'll now request everyone to please stand up for the national anthem.
Paper that we need to conduct two tail tests or one tail test as far as exception or rejection of the hypothesis there. So what I did in this hypothesis, I have to check only one sided test, that means whether it is the more effective on positive side or not. That's why I maintain the one tail region of acceptance. That means I have to accept whether if it will be the positive, then it will be accepted, otherwise it will not be accepted. That's why I go for the one tail test for the purpose of the study.
मैं उसी पेपर को आप लोगों के लिए वहाँ पर कुछ डिफाइन करने की कोशिश करूँगा। page number 46, role and opportunities and challenges of HR analytics in business. The how HR analytics is going to be play a major role in your business. The main paper, the main theme is that. Now, the first thing is you should know about the HR analytics and what is exactly analytics says. If I say HR analytics, it means analytical part which is related to HR. So HR analytics is a statistical method which play a role like a tool to acquire the data, analyze the data, and especially to show something in a systematic way. This part is analytical. And second thing, the most important thing, if we can say something about the future of that data, this part is analytical, analytics. Now, there are so many definitions you can easily find in the paper, in the Google. So I am not going to read all the definitions that I have written in my paper, but one definition I am going to read for you. HR analytics is a methodology that uses statistical tools and techniques to unify and evaluate employees' quantitative and qualitative data that help in bringing out the meaningful insights to develop better future decisions making. It means the definition is saying that if you have a good data, a qualitative type of data, then you can take a good decisions, especially on the HR data. Now, जब हम HR data की बात कर रहे हैं, तो सबसे पहले analytical part की बात करेंगे, तो analytics हमें ये मालूम होना चाहिए कि how many types are analytics in there. Although in Google you can easily find कि चार तरह का analytical tools हैं, जिनको हम लोग types of analytical tools बोल रहे हैं. But in deep, if you will know, then you will find that only three kind of categories are there. The first one is descriptive, that describe the data on the basis of past data that is already available. Second and third, the second number one is the predictive, that shows some kind of predictions on the basis of our past data. And third one, that is parallel with the second one, diagnostic analysis, it shows if it is happening or it happens, then why it is happening. It means ye a kind of doctor hota na, diagnosis karte hain. The same time, here is the data which diagnose some kind of information ki if it is happening, then why it is happening. And the fourth one is prescriptive data. It means agar doctor ne kisi cheez ka diagnosis kiya hai, to then usko prescription bhi dena padega. So what will be happening in future if you will go through this data? इस तरह का जो इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोवाइड करता है, that will be under the category of prescriptive analysis. Now, the next phase में अगर हम आगे बढ़ेंगे, तो now we will find कि जो मेरे पेपर में that is available in the souvenir, the nature of the paper is descriptive as well as conceptual, and for this kind of paper, this kind of research, I have chosen mostly the secondary data that is available on website, some of the journals, even some books that are easily available. And the coverage of the data is starting from 2016 to 2021, because it was a phase in India also and even in the world also when most of the companies were focusing on analysis part. इससे पहले हम लोग HR के पार्ट में एनालिसिस नहीं करते थे. We just focus कि एक employee है, उसका ID note कर लिया गया, उसका certificate note कर लिया गया, and then उसको एक particular department में, where जहाँ पर उसको requirement थी, उसको वहाँ पर भेज दिया गया. जैसा कि marketing definition कहती है कि to right people should be at the right place. तो right place पर उसको भेज दिया गया. But after 2016, अगर किसी person से पूछा दिया कि if a person is working over there, what is its productivity? So productivity को judge करने के लिए किसी तरह का data हमारे पास available नहीं था. So the part, जो analysis part था, ये वही data पर आ रहा है. Now 2016 को 2021 तक मेरा ये data available था. Objective जो है available, जो objective है behind the paper, to define analytical function in human resource management. It means again, I am saying it shows more and more analysis part other than just functions of HR. And second one, determines the risk and potential benefits of using the
मतलब लिटरेट होने
मैं एमबीए करने के बाद भी जब वहां गए तो मुझे एनएस के बारे में कोई जानकारी नहीं थी। मैं उन्हीं के अंडर में काम कर रहा था। जब मुझे फर्स्ट टाइम बताया गया देन आई वाज शॉक्ड। मेरे लिए नया था दिया एनआईसी में डेटा है, सारा डेटा क्लाउड पे है और क्लाउड कहां है वो एनआईसी के पास है। सो डेटा को लेना भी एक चैलेंज है अभी। एंड द लास्ट वन द कंक्लूजन इन माय पेपर यू विल फाइंड कि ऑल्दो इट इज द इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स बट इंप्लीमेंटिंग द एचआर एनालिटिक्स इन बिजनेस इज क्वाइट डिफिकल्ट बिकॉज ऑफ skill, because of investment. HR workers may not have the necessary expertise. Thus, the important point sir, मैंने बोला बोला कि expertise उतना नहीं है HR के पास जो हमारे employees हैं और उनकी skills को बढ़ाने के लिए उतना important तरीके से या उतना priority basis पे काम भी नहीं हो रहा। सिर्फ काम हो रहा है, उतना priority basis पे काम नहीं हो रहा। The second thing कि if you will learn something, you can enhance your abilities, your skills to work with this kind of किसी भी कंपनी में अगर आप एचआर एनालिस्ट को यूज करेंगे एटलीस्ट इसके लिए एक ह्यूज इन्वेस्टमेंट चाहिए। एंड सेकंड वन, ये एक लॉन्ग टर्म प्रोसेस है। आज की डेट में अगर आप इंप्लीमेंट करते हैं तो आपको ये उम्मीद नहीं करनी चाहिए कि विद इन 6 मंथ और इवन विद इन 1 मंथ आई विल गेट अ गुड रिजल्ट। सो इट इज अ लॉन्ग टर्म प्रोसेस। द लास्ट वन, एचआर एनालिस्ट में ग्रो ट्रेमेंडसली विद द टाइम। टाइम के साथ ये ग्रो कर रहा है। जैसा मैंने बताया फ्रॉम 16 टू 21 मैंने डेटा लिया है। नंबर ऑफ कंपनीज हु आर ऑप्टिंग द एचआर एनालिस्ट आर इंक्रीजिंग डे बाय डे। जैसा शुरुआत मैंने आपको एक हिंट दिया कि आई हैव वर्क विद अ वेब्रो कंपनी एज अ प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजर इन 2008। एट द मोमेंट केवल और केवल 6 कंपनीज थी जो एचआर एनालिस्ट एम्प्लॉइज पर काम कर रही थी विद द गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस। बट नाउडेज सिनेरियो काफी चेंज हो चुका है। मोर देन 600 कंपनीज आर वर्किंग विद डायरेक्ट कनेक्शन विद सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट। स्टेट गवर्नमेंट की तो बात छोड़ दें। सो इट वाज माय पेपर। इफ यू हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ क्वेरी प्लीज आस्क। थैंक यू। श्योर फिटेड नंबर ऑफ इसको
या
या
द आंसर इज बेसिकली द एचआर इज बेसिकली कंबाइनिंग टू मेन फंक्शन दैट इज द फंक्शनल एंड द बिहेवियर राइट। सो दे नीड व्हाट दे नीड अ पर्सन हु वी हैव बोथ दिस
बोथ दिस
एंड गेटिंग अ पर्सन हु इज हैविंग both these skills is
limited.
Also, nowadays HR is moving not only limited to the hugging and mugging. It is going beyond the limits, and it is actually talking about the strategic HR management.
Yes.
So when you were talking about sir this HR analytics, it is a very broad topic, right?
Exactly.
I think you first need to focus on that which section of the HR analytics you are talking about, because analytics is what analytics. Just a small solution, sir. With this is a broad topic, getting a specific research question and specific is difficult. Now I request Mr. Sudhanshu Singh to present his paper.
Paper which has a topic namely spirituality practices and sustainable workplace. With my faculty, Dr. Priya, Assistant Professor IMS, Lucknow University. So, I would like to leave you with the abstract part of the paper. And this has a theme on spirituality and spiritual intelligence, and how it helps the employee and the employer to motivate the organizational work culture. Spirituality is the condition of having a close interaction with one's inner moral and ethical self, as well as realizing one's own true nature. The idea of spirituality at work can be defined as an interconnectedness shared by everyone engaged in the work process, initially sparked by the realization that each person is motivated by an inner force that uplifts and maintains his or her sense of honesty, kindness and courage, ultimately leading to the collective creation of an aesthetically motivating environment marked by a sense of purpose, high ethical standards and accepted behavior. A humanistic workforce climate fosters innovation, which is why many businesses are supporting the growth of this new trend. The paper emphasizes the collective contribution of spirituality and spiritual intelligence at sustainable workplace, producing a sustainable work culture. In this paper, the author makes an effort to dispose the irrationality or myths pertaining to spirituality that is aloof from mainstream management contribution. Today is a time of modernization, and people who have faith in this time trend to think that spirituality is something which is quite distinct from postmodern subjectivity. In this paper, the reader will find how spirituality has an ability to enhance the performance of not only the employee, but a holistic increment in the performance of the organization just by following the basics of combination of spirituality and spiritual intelligence, which follows by keywords as spirituality, spiritual intelligence, sustainability, employee well-being and work culture. Now, I would like to start off with the introduction part. Spirituality, as I already mentioned, is nowadays becoming a hot topic in both media and academia. Spirituality is now seen as a universal human practice. People or organizations which were well apt with spirituality and have high spiritual intelligence usually outperform. An evaluation of these trends is attempted by studying the concept in its original context and by understanding the development of the dichotomy between religion and spirituality. Let's move on to the objectives. This paper emphasizes on the collective contribution of spirituality and spiritual intelligence at sustainable workplace, producing a sustainable work culture. In this paper, the author makes an effort to dispose the irrationality or myths pertaining to spirituality that is aloof from the mainstream management contribution. Characteristics of a workplace practicing spirituality: sustainable development, commitment to value contribution, encouraging originality, stimulates development and establishes values and principles. Let's move on to the perspectives of spirituality. Mainly, we have discussed about three perspectives of spirituality. And the first one goes with the human resource perspective. In this, first of all, let's understand what we as authors want to deliver when we talk about perspective. Perspective on how spirituality enables one to lead with good and efficient organizational performance. The HR, the human resource perspective is particularly silent in today's workplaces, where employees spend most of their lives and spirituality in order enhances employee well-being and quality of life. Spirituality also enhances the general well-being of employees by enhancing their morale. Now, let's come on to the philosophical perspective. Philosophical perspective is related to the concept such as the search of meaning and purpose in what what employees are doing in the today's present scenario pertaining to the workplace structure. Then the last one is the interpersonal perspective. Interpersonal perspective is centered on the interpersonal relationships, collective dimensions, and social perspective of spirituality, which in and out help them to perform efficiently and create a acceptable and efficient organizational culture. Let's talk about the contribution of spirituality at workplace. It encourages inclusion, value creation and value contribution. Organizational performance is positively affected by workplace spirituality. A significant relationship exists between organizational performance and organizational spirituality, which leads to higher individual performance. Team performance is positively associated with the workplace spirituality. And these are some conclusion and recommendation. Spirituality in the workplace is also referred to as workplace spirituality, which is relatively a recent concept. In a newer phenomena that is gaining popularity all around the world, it is recommended to do not accept jobs simply because it pays well and has many benefits. Some professions might not fit with your moral principles, and it might be challenging to build any kind of workplace spirituality. Thank you. We can go with some administrative questions.
What has been the paper's contribution to the topic?
Sir, see, the paper's contribution, as the name itself suggests, that is sustainable development and growth. The paper wants to tell that if there is a work culture which is sustainable, and we include the spiritual practices which should not be confused with religious practices, it in a way helps out the employees to outperform and build a sustainable organizational culture, and also motivates the employees to outperform by simply performing the basics of spirituality.
Any other perspective of spirituality which your contribution would have come here? Any other apart from these three?
No, I haven't.
Yeah. Okay. Any other point?
आपके रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस जो हैं वो एक एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव पार्ट है आपकी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का, लेकिन जो स्पिरिचुअलिटी होती है उस जो आपके रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस हैं उसको रिलीजियसली आप कैसे फॉलो कर सकते हैं, वो एक मीडियम है, वो एक आधार है. स्पिरिचुअलिटी को जो है आप एक एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव जो मतलब एक प्रोसेस है वो मत समझिए. रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस को कैसे फॉलो करना है ऑन द बेसिक नेचर ऑफ स्पिरिचुअलिटी, वो एक माध्यम है, एक मीडियम है कि आप कैसे जो है इफेक्टिव ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल कल्चर बना सकते हैं स्पिरिचुअल के बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट को फॉलो करके.
अच्छा, व्हाट इज द स्पिरिचुअल
कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्पिरिचुअलिटी? इज नथिंग बट समथिंग व्हिच इज वे मच अलूफ फ्रॉम रिलीजियस प्रैक्टिसेस. Nowadays people get confused with spiritual practices and religious practices. ऐसा नहीं होता है. Spiritual practice, spirituality जो है वो आती है जब किसी के अंदर एक spiritual intelligence होता है. And what is spiritual intelligence? Spiritual intelligence is the intelligence of soul. That's it.
Then what is soul?
अब सर soul इतना तो मैंने कहने नहीं किया है.
Spirituality और
आपका सवाल मैं समझ नहीं पा
रहा
हूँ. पहले से समझाने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ. रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस को फॉलो करने का एक तरीका ये भी हो सकता है कि आप स्पिरिचुअलिटी के बेसिक नेचर को जो है आप पढ़ें, उसको समझें और एक इफेक्टिव जो ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल वर्क कल्चर है उसको आप कैसे डेवलप कर सकते हैं और स्पिरिचुअलिटी के बेसिस पर आप अपने एम्प्लॉयज को कैसे मोटिवेट कर सकते हो, ये इस पेपर का आधार.
वार मिश्रा टू रिप्रेजेंट हिज पेपर.
स्कूल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट साइंस तक टुडे आई एम हियर टू प्रेजेंट द पेपर एंटायर द लिटरेचर व्यू ऑफ ब्लॉकचेन एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन इन द नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन द SDG 9 इंडस्ट्री इनोवेशन एंड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय SMS लखनऊ. वी आर ऑल्सो थैंक जजका मैम, शी ऑल्सो हेल्प मी इन दिस पेपर and we presented our paper. When we are talking about our paper, so we can introduce a blockchain. Blockchain technology is a peer-to-peer architecture network. It is decentralized and complex of a series of blocks. It is also referred to as distributed ledger technology, which preserves the calculation of all. And we are used in the keyword is like a blockchain, decentralized, distributed, ledger, secure. And we are talking about the blockchain. So it's mainly four types: public blockchain, private blockchain, hybrid blockchain, and consultant blockchains. In the public blockchain, a public blockchain is an open source, decentralized blockchain with no restrictions of the user that can participate in the network. Public blockchains, by its design, are the best for protecting users' anonymity. Since this type of blockchain is publicly accessible to all users, the decisions there are made by several process algorithms such as POW, means a proof of work, and the POS, proof of step, and many more. Public blockchain platforms include Bitcoin and Ethereum, etc. And the second one is private blockchain. Private blockchain restricts the user who can participate and make a transaction in the network. The centralized architecture of a private blockchain makes it more prone to security breaches. Private blockchain platform include Hyperledger, Hashgraph, Polda, and many others. And the concept from blockchain. A concept from blockchain is a partially decentralized blockchain, which means it lies in between a public and a private blockchain. Consultant blockchain does not allow anybody to enter the network. Instead, it requires the permission of the network admin to grant access to someone. The example of the consultant code blockchain is like the RZ, OLA, etc. When we are talking about the hybrid blockchain, according to the name, hybrid blockchain is a combination of both the public blockchain and the private blockchain. The hybrid blockchain is not entirely open to everyone. Certain restrictions are posted while allowing participants to enter. center, the hybrid blockchain network. Hybrid blockchain is controlled by a group of individuals. The transactions are made as kept private and yet can be verified whenever needed. Hybrid blockchain platform include Dragon Chain. When we talk about the methodology, so blockchain technology works by creating an environment that is secure and transparent for the financial transactions of the virtual values, such as Bitcoin. The blockchain network is a decentralized structure that consists of scattered nodes that inspect and validate the authenticity of any new transaction that attempts to take place. This combined agreement is done through several consensus models by the process of mining. Once a transaction can be validated and agreed upon by all the nodes, it then gets added to the digital ledger and protected using cryptography that uses a public key that is accessible to all the other nodes. When we are talking about the block structure, so its main part is main data, block will contain transaction data, and the second one is timestamp. The timestamp will also exist in the block. Here the timestamp refers to the data and time when a particular block is generated, and then a hash. The hash corresponding to each block is a unique identifier that is generated using a cryptographic hash algorithm such as SHA-256. Is a type of algorithm. Hash makes the block created. Hashes are generated using the Markov-Chain function. It is stored in the header of the block. And we are talking about the applications of blockchain. So it is mainly the healthcare, unique crowdfunding, banking, smart delivery systems. The first healthcare to prevent health data from falling on the wrong hands and to prevent misuse of these data public, blockchain can be used where health data can be seen by the doctor on the owner of the data, that is the patient premises. Equity crowdfunding. Getting money from crowd or suppose a company product in exchange for equity share in the company, known as equity crowdfunding. To maintain a fair ground around fundraise and investors, blockchain technology can be used. And the banking sector, when someone lying about paying tax, blockchain can immediately give the correct information about tax. It can be reduced that fraud. And the smart delivery system, this proves that the making sure we get the right product in order online can be the job for distributing companies. Smart contract-based blockchain can make sure that the right person gets the item. Secret code can be separated between seller and buyer. Once item reaches its destination, previously shared secret code will complete the contract. And the final conclusion, the future of blockchain predictively holds some significant advancements in technology. As the future scope, the foremost priority is to handle the several security issues in different areas using blockchain technology. Any question?
Dr. Uruz Ahmed to present his paper. Good morning, all dignitaries present here, my co-workers and colleagues, all the research community, conference attendees and the students. So I am Dr. Anuj Ahmed Sadiqi, Assistant Professor in Institute of Management Sciences, University of Lucknow. So recently I have just started working on a paper that is determining the impact of social media marketing on buying behavior focusing digital consumers. So I am going through the literature review phase of this paper, and I am just on the verge of completion of the literature review. So this paper basically reviews the literature and proposes a conceptual framework for hypothesis testing in future. So, viral marketing is the buzzword today, and it is also known as the social media marketing. And if we visit the Philip Kotler, Philip Kotler says that viral marketing is a part of word of mouth, and it has basically two components, that is buzz marketing and viral marketing. So the buzz marketing basically it is stimulating consumers regarding the products or brand to spread the information physically from one person to another. And when the same thing is done online, it is called viral marketing. And the most favorite mode to do viral marketing for companies today is social media marketing. So social media marketing is a form of originates from the viral marketing, and it may include different stimulus. It may be form of the information of the product, brand, audio, video, infographics, small jokes, and anything that is being posted on the social media for the consumption of consumers, and with the expectations that the consumers will pass on this information to the other consumers. So now viral marketing, actually the strategic context is once Bill Gates said that the companies should visit where the consumers are, and recently most of the consumers are on the internet, and this can be taken from that India's internet penetration is more than 50% with 749 million internet users, and these figures are slated to grow very very fast, and it is estimated that in 2025 there will be 974 plus million internet users, with 67% of them using the social media. That is 650 million users will be using social media by 2025. So if we follow the Bill Gates, so companies should proceed or visit where the consumers are, and consumers are more about on the internet and social media websites like Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, LinkedIn, and many others to be listed. Now, in foreign countries, companies like P&G, Amazon, Unilever, Yahoo, and other big companies have leveraged this social media for promoting their product, and studies suggest that they have been able to reduce their budget, their promotional budget, significantly through the use of this social media. So in India, we still have some companies are there that are leveraging, but largely this opportunity has not yet been used or employed by the companies. So this study basically tries to determine what are the social media efforts that are being followed by different companies, and what is their impact on the purchase intent and attitude towards that. So while performing the literature review, basically whenever the companies go viral and they want to share their content with the consumers, so the three important aspects are sharing, how the material will be shared, through which website, through which networking website, Then the shared content. What is the shared content? Whether it is an image, an audio, a video, or some interactive material. And the third thing is the online platform. So the important thing is, it is being expected the messages will be passed on from consumer to consumer. So while the individuals or groups are there, the communities are there, so product services are provided by the company, information is provided by the company to these groups, and the shared content basically may be text, visual content, multimedia, infographics, notes, discussions, and links. So, and already I have discussed the website or blogs and the platform through which they are being discussed. So, while performing the literature review, I have come across several models. One of the important models was given by Kaitzman 2012, that is Honeycomb model with seven functional blocks of leveraging and creating viral marketing. Campaigns are presence, sharing, relationship, identity, conversion, groups, and reputation. So, with this framework, I have consulted and I have been through many studies which basically present the form of the viral marketing and determine the variables. So, basically, while performing the literature review, I have found out that viral marketing efforts don't have a direct effect on the purchase intent, but most importantly, they help in building the attitude of the consumers towards the product or the brand which is being promoted through social media. Now, I have figured out the main variables that are, or the main factors that are important for social media marketing that the firms are using recently. The important ones are the informative messages that contains the information about the product or the brand. They are basically for creating awareness. The second is the entertaining content, that some form of joke or some form of meme which are being presented to the consumers, and out of curiosity and out of interest, they are interested in sharing that content to the other consumers. Then targeted customized content. Targeted customized content is a very important aspect that is being used by the companies. In this type of content, consumers, through the use of artificial intelligence and all the technology, they try to determine what the consumers are looking at this particular time. And they send the customized message to individual customers about their present need and present want. So basically, performing the result or conclusion of the performing the literature review was identifying the main variables which are actually affecting the attitudes of the brand and brand purchase attention. So I have conceptualized this model which I will try to validate and test in the future. The main variables are consumer interaction, entertaining efforts, viral marketing, informative efforts, customized viral marketing efforts, and then engagement that involves e-word of mouth. These all variables affect attitude towards brand, and attitude towards brand leads to the brand purchase intention. So this is the conceptual framework that I have come with, and in future I will prepare a questionnaire, collect the data, and try to validate the scale and test the hypothesis. So these are the research hypothesis that I have formulated. Thank you. Any questions or suggestions that are more important that I may improve my model or the study?
How do you think is the digital engagement correlated to the system?
Digital engagement is something which are being used by the companies all over the world to reduce the cost of the promotion. So, when we enter into the domain of promotion, it is one of the piece that involves cost of around 20 to 30%. So whatever we buy a product, there are four P's: product, price, promotion and place. So the promotion part contributes up to the 30% cost of the product. So if we are promoting through some innovative and digital techniques, then we are able to reduce that cost, promotion cost, and we can reduce the price. And ultimately, when we are reducing the price, we are reducing the consumption of resources. It leads to the sustainability, less usage of the resources, and more efficient production and more efficient business.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Any other query?
Any other queries?
No. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Now I request Mr. Saurabh Banerjee to present his paper.
Sustainability, green marketing, etc. I have chosen to talk about and share my views about EngadTech. There was already one paper. So this is merger and acquisition, a tool of survival and sustainability in the cutthroat world of competition. And the lessons are from Indian cases as well as the world. This is a meta-analysis, and I wish to do either primary database or secondary database study later on. As of now, this is just a synthesis of all previous researchers and filtered from different domains. So friendly mergers, although we'll talk about different other classifications of mergers, but just in a lighter vein, and just to make sure that everybody is awake, now the lunchtime is coming in, that friendly mergers are any day better than a hostile one. Chahe shaadi ho, ya chahe merger ho, to dostane tarike se hi honi chahiye. Aur nahi to kya hoga, wo khud shayad keh rahe hain, ishq jab ek taraf ho to saza deta hai. आपके डर जाऊंगा इश्क अगर एक तरफ हो तो सजा देता है मुझे हॉस्टाइल मार्जर और अगर दोनों तरफ हो तो मजा देता है मुझे फ्रेंडली मार्जर तो कहने का मतलब दोनों तरफ से रजामंदी होनी चाहिए तो वो मर्जर वो एक्विजिशन वो टेकओवर थोड़ा लॉन्ग लास्टिंग होगा और सस्टेनेबल भी होगा ड्यूरेबल होगा और नहीं तो फिर मामला जैसे फैमिली कोर्ट में पहुंचता है वैसे फिर लिटिगेशन और कोर्ट में पहुंचेगा सुप्रीम कोर्ट में पहुंचेगा इंटरनेशनल कोर्ट ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन में भी पहुंचता है सो फ्रॉम बायोलॉजिकल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू चार्ल्स डार्विन ने भी कहा था कि सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट फॉर ऑल थिंग्स लिविंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इंक्लूडेड क्योंकि ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को भी हम लिविंग थिंग्स ही मानते हैं लिविंग एंटिटी मानते हैं ग्रोथ इज गिवन वी हैव टू ग्रो अदरवाइज Our growth will be stagnant. पानी अगर स्थिर हो जाए तो वहाँ एनिफिलिस मच्छर बढ़ने लगते हैं वहाँ मलेरिया और डेंगू के बीमारी फैलने लगती है और ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अगर स्थिर हो जाए तो उसका फिर खात्मा ही होगा सो वी हैव टू ग्रो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एज टू अब सवाल ये है हाउ टू तो देयर आर टू वेज टू ग्रो एक को कहते हैं ऑर्गेनिक ग्रोथ एंड अदर वन इज इनऑर्गेनिक ग्रोथ सो फाइटिंग फॉर मार्केट शेयर प्रॉफिट and go for the long haul. That is the organic way of growth. कि हम अपने geographical footprint बढ़ाएंगे, दुबई में भी बेचेंगे, US में अपने office खोलेंगे, etc. The other shortcut method is inorganic growth, where merger and acquisition is one of the process. Although this is not the one, there are other techniques of joint venture, subsidiary, and so on and so forth. However, having said this, M&A is no magic bullet for sure short success. We'll see some statistics. कितने percent success में कितने percent success नहीं हुए. Marriages are made in heaven, but many make up in family courts. And M&A, they are made in boardroom. But 50-80% they end up in litigations and bankruptcies. Now reasons of failure. Misplaced objectives. As we know, if the objective, whether it is a research or whether it is anything, whether it is life, agar objective mein hi kuch khamiya reh jaye, to uska end result will be suspect. Bloated valuation. While evaluating a company to take over, now many other things rather than the financial perspective and ego, prestige issue of the promoter, acquiring promoter and the acquired promoter, they come in. HR issues like synergy, Air India or Air India? Indian Airlines and Air India. एक फैमिलियर केस स्टडी है, हमारे एचआर के कलीग्स पढ़ाते होंगे। एक जगह हुआ करता था 5 डेज पे, एक जगह हुआ करता था 6 डेज पे, मर्जर हो गया सब। और सालों तक यही झगड़ा चलता रहा कि 5 डेज पे वहां पे लोग काम कर रहे हैं, वो 6 डेज पे काम कर रहा है, तो हमको क्या कह रहे हैं ऐसा करके। एंड ओवरऑल इट वाज अ फेलियर। अभी तो खैर टाटा कोई बिग नहीं कंपनी, अब टाटा का कुछ यूनिफाइड एचआर पॉलिसीज ला रहा है। लैक ऑफ सिनर्जी। आरके लक्ष्मण का बड़ा एक फेमस कार्टून है, लक्ष्मण साहब का गुजर गया लेकिन उनकी कार्टून आज तक मौजूद है। मैनेजमेंट में अक्सर क्या होता है कि गाड़ी इस तरह से है, दो घोड़े इधर बांध दिए, दो घोड़े इधर बांध दिए, सो वन इज पुलिंग टुवर्ड्स द ईस्ट, वन इज पुलिंग, वन गियर इज पुलिंग टुवर्ड्स द वेस्ट, नेट रिजल्ट इज जीरो। फिजिक्स में कहते हैं कि वर्क इज एफ इनटू वी डिस्प्लेसमेंट, जब तक डिस्प्लेसमेंट होगा नहीं वर्क जीरो है, और जब तक कोऑर्डिनेशन होगा नहीं तो नेट इफेक्ट जीरो। तो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में भी मर्जर एंड एक्विजिशन ऑफन कम्स टू दिस इफेक्ट। बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट चेंजेस। So post GST, post COVID, post regulation, there are many factors, business environment, external or internal, that gets changed, and that has got impact on the success of the merger and acquisition. Lapses in managing IP or intellectual property rights and intellectual property rights related litigations, if they are not managed in a time bound manner, then this merger and acquisition, all these cases are bound to fail. And then there are certain other factors also. This is not an exhaustive list of all the factors of failures. We'll quickly touch on the merger and acquisition basics. Merger hote kisko nahi hota kya? Two or more approximately equal size organization get together to form one enterprise. Identical terms are amalgamation, consolidation, integration, and so on. Acquisition, which is a little bit of variation of merger, how it is different? Like a big fish follows a smaller one, a large organization acquires a smaller firm, although there is an exception. Sometimes a smaller company buys a bigger one. In the animal kingdom, badi machli choti machli ko kha jati hai. Merger acquisition ke case mein ek choti machli bhi badi machli ko kha sakti hai. So you can have a control stake, even at a 10% shareholder. Mergers can be friendly, two or more parties are willing. And friendly merger when the acquisition is desired by both the parties or more than all the parties. कभी कभी तीन चार पार्टी मिलकर भी मर्जर हो सकता है। Examples, Tata Tea merged with Consolidated Coffee and so on. Assam Coffee. Friendly and backward forward vertical integration is strategies के topic है। How do you ensure your raw material supply and downstream suppliers, downstream vendors and so on and so forth. Vodafone taking over management aging is one of the examples. So when managers, not all managers are unfortunately friendly. So they are called hostile managers. बगैर रजामंदी के भी मर्जर होते हैं। एनडीटीवी को अडानी ने टेक ओवर किया, दादा तरीन एग्जाम्पल है। उसमें प्रणय रॉय की रजामंदी थी या नहीं थी डजंट मैटर। व्हाइट नाइट, ये एक टेक्निकल टर्म है व्हाइट नाइट अबाउट मर्जर एंड एक्विजिशन। एक्वायरर ए, एक एग्जांपल हाइपोथेटिकल एग्जांपल लेते हैं कि ए बी को खरीदना चाहता है और सी उसको हेल्प कर रहा है उसको खरीदने को बंद करने में, सो सी इज अ व्हाइट नाइट। There are many things, I'll just skip and I'll come to conclusion because time is limited, resources are limited. There are some stats, national and international stats here, कि कब कितने बड़े मर्जर हुए, इसमें इंडियन भी हैं, फॉरेनर भी हैं, etc. So we'll quickly go to conclusion and then I'll take up some questions and queries and comments. M&A, as we said, as we have seen, it's not a magic bullet. Results have been mixed. Instead of unequivocal success or failure, manufacturing sector, other than ROC, return on capital employed, many proxies return zero or negative returns. और भी proxies हैं merger and acquisition के success निकालने का, तो वो पता लगा कि return जो है आजकल zero है या negative, तो कहने का मतलब कोई sense नहीं बनता था जाने का। Some marginal increases or decreases were not statistically significant. Even if there is a return, that is not statistically significant. So an animal instinct of growing inorganically needs to be tempered with rationalization, utmost viability, financial strategy, HR and legal due diligence. Without due diligence, merger and acquisition is one thing. Failure. Type of industry impacts the post-merger operating performance of acquiring firms in India. That has been studied by group researchers. Many studies give a before and after analysis. So whether there is a positive impact or not, but the effects were not statistically significant to the debate and chaos continued. Fred David, X-Tax, but 80% of the mergers, they end up in failure. For manufacturing companies, Mishra and his researchers in 2012 study found out that the liquidity position improved, but it was not statistically significant. And so on and so forth. During the scandal, 1990s or 2000, I remember scandals like Enron, Pricewaterhouse, Satyam Computers, Hindustan Bank. So the bottom line is, most of them, they were not sustainable. Merger and acquisition success metric is not just the financial performance, HR issues, culture and practice also make M&A the main or great story. And as many M&A deals are revealed with conflict of interest issues, highlighted above, regulators could do well to disseminate information, helping inform choice for disputed owners of public companies, जिसमें सेबी का रोल आता है और इंटरनेशनल रेगुलेटर्स का रोल भी आता है. एवरेज एमएनए ट्रांजैक्शंस इन यूएस ओवर द स्पेक्ट्रम ऑफ प्राइवेट पब्लिक एंड टारगेट ओनर्स ऑफ पब्लिक कंपनी लीडर्स एंड फॉर पब्लिक टारगेट्स आर गुड स्वैट सो एंड नॉट सो गुड. सो देयर आर सम रेफरेंस हियर. आई लव टू गेट योर कमेंट्स. थैंक यू फॉर योर अटेंशन.
एनी क्वेश्चन? Yes,
please.
Government
का रोल
मर्जर
सर गवर्नमेंट का रोल क्या होता है मर्जर एंड एक्विजिशन में? फॉर एग्जाम्पल एजीसी एंड अडानी, फॉर एग्जाम्पल एजीसी एंड अडानी,
मैंने जिक्र किया है सेबी के रोल है, आरबीआई के रोल है, मोनोपोली. Merger has got one objective and regulators have got a controlling objective that the monopoly is not created. If hypothetically, agar aaj ki date mein Jio aa jaye, sara kuch control kar le telecom market, Vodafone ICU mein hai, BSNL band hone wali hai, sarkar ke chande pe chal rahi hai, khuda na kare kal ko Jio pura control kar le telecom India, pura Hindustan ka, to kya hoga? Jio will be at the hum jaise customers will be at the mercy of the Jio. They can increase the price like anything and they can do whatever they like. Is tarah ke monopoly na create ho jaye. Microsoft ke paas 85% market share hai, Intel ke paas 80% market share hai, aur aap dekh rahe hain ki Google ke upar tamam tarah ke restrictions lagaye ja rahe hain CCI ki taraf se, Competition Commission of India. If they implement a lot of bad practices to control the competition, to force their own rules. So, isme aapne jaise pucha hai, is SEBI, RBI, etc. They are all working to make those comply with the law. Isi tarah se international bodies. Anything else? Thank you so much. Thank you for the attention.